behind me you can see all the different parts that have been changed for the new Bentley Continental GT. As you can see, this is a rough shape. They tried to make it a bit more swooping, and if you check out this one behind me, you can see that a lot has changed, but it's still a very recognizable Bentley Continental GT. Okay, so at the back you can see that it's a lot more swooping. We have an integrated spoiler in here. We have all new rear lights, which are much more compact and sort of oval shaped, which is really, really beautiful, I think. We have new exhaust, a new bumper, everything is new. And as you probably know, the first generation Continental GT was based on the VW Phaeton. The second generation was a big facelift. But this third generation has been developed sort of together with the new Porsche Panamera. So the base is much better and the body is much, much better than before as well. The fact that this generation is all new is very clear when you sit in here, because it's ridiculously beautiful. We have insane amounts of wood. There's 10 square meters of wood in here. We have an all new center console with this ridiculous flipping screen. That's just one of the most ridiculously cool things ever in a car. So this one, the new Continental GT, is now only available with a 6-liter W12 engine. It will be available with a V8, of course, and different models like the Speed and the Supersport. This all new W12 engine is the one from the Bentayga, so it has 626 horsepower, 900 newton meters. This huge thing will go from 0 to 100 kilometers an hour in 3.6 seconds. Top speed 333 kilometers an hour. This is a serious machine. It's 80 kilos lighter than the previous one. It's bigger, it's wider, it's even a bit higher, but because the wheelbase has been extended by about 9 centimeters, the car looks altogether much more agile. Okay, so one of the biggest changes on the new Continental GT is the front, because these ones have grown. This one is smaller and the grille altogether is wider, bigger, but has still that sort of chrome black look that we know from the Continental GT.